Welcome back, ZeroK fans. So there's been some adjustments. It looks like Drone and Average Plan were together, and then Drone apparently team-killed Average Plan. So I'm not sure what's happening there. I think Kshatriya might be taking Drone's place. I have no idea. That's really bizarre. Anyway, I do want to watch the game between them and Spring and Dawn. But I don't know where that is. Okay, perfect. Now I know where it is. So we're going to be having a match between... It looks like Kshatriya will be replacing Drone now that... Yeah, okay, Kshatriya has replaced Drone, because apparently Drone really does not want to play, to the point that they team-killed, which is really bizarre. Anyhow, Kshatriya and Average Plan versus Spring and Dawn. That will be the next... Or Sprang and Dawn. That'll be the next game, and we're on round two. Don't know what map going to be. So that was really strange. Team killing in a tournament is not something that's generally considered to be good form. Gotta be honest. That was... kind of a low blow. Not really sure what the motivation there was. Anyway, doesn't really matter. What matters right now is what the next map is going to be. I don't know what that is. I also don't know where Dawn is, for that matter. Oh, they are here. Where is the map choice? Well, maybe they are just playing Cold Snap then. I don't know. We might be seeing a lot of Cold Snap. I mean, best of one, I almost think they that Sortel probably should have put in a map for each round. That's usually what happens. The first match of each round has a set map, and then every subsequent round, if it's more than best of one, will have loser's choice. Because right now, it's like, how do you choose? Who chooses? Do you have all the players just pick together? I mean, it's not like you're having them go back and forth saying, no, I don't want to play this map, no, I don't want to play that map, until finally you get a map. That looks like we're on Cold Snap again, because that's what was there. All right, we are going now, finally. So I'm curious to see how these players play. I basically wanted to cast them because I casted none of these players last game. I really want to see how these teams work, especially since Kshatriya and Average Plan have just now started teaming up. I mean, there was some weird confusion going on, and I think a couple people were here but didn't show up into the tournament room. You mentioned tournament chat. There's a tournament chat room. At any rate, we are once again back on Cold Snap. Curious if we're going to see another drop strategy like last time, or if we're going to see something a little bit more typical. I mean, I do like the fact that the drop strategy led into a more normal game, but it does kind of suck for... I mean, okay, admittedly, Sprung and Hokomoka still won that. I mean, they didn't win it with the drop strategy, but they didn't lose it because the drop strategy failed. They still won. So good on them. And it looks like Kshatriya might be going for a bit of a counterattack. Okay, we'll see what they go for. Average Plan wants to go for the drop. Dawn going for Spiderbot Factory, which is interesting. And I don't see where Sprang is right now. Where is Sprang? Oh, hey, we got a clan this time around. Team XCOM. Actually, can I change that? Nope. Okay, anyway. So, Western team, not setting up yet. Okay, where are they going? Okay, so Kshatriya and Average Plan going to be playing more normally. Don going for Spiderbot Factory, which to me implies they're going to be playing more normally. I know that sounds a little weird. It's like, spiders are playing normally? Well, they don't really have, other than maybe Hermitrop, much of an early rush option. Like, you scout with fleas, and then you attack with whatever. Like, you get stuff that works. Now, of course, Hermitrop is an option. And if Sprang goes for Gunship, then I'm guessing Hermitrop is the option. But it's not typical. For Hermit, like, yeah, okay, Sprang going further south. I don't think it's going to be a drop. It looks like it's probably going to be something a bit more typical. Though Sprang is close enough that it could be a Gunship plant right after this. Nope, nothing yet. Don going pretty normal. Kshatriya and Average Plan going for, okay, center and south, Clokey and light vehicle. So West team playing pretty typical, XCON team playing also fairly typical, Spider and Light Vehicle. We look like we are going to have a relatively straightforward game now. And at this point, Kshatriya's Factorous has been revealed. No revelation for Sprang's Factor Choice yet, but now it will be. Sorry, Average Plans. Sprang as well, actually, come to think of it. So now everyone knows what is going on, and right now, I'd say the Western team is a bit of an advantage just for positioning. I mean, especially with those defenders being done at this point. Ooh. Okay, Scorcher got rid of a Slasher. If it weren't in enemy territory, I'd say that was more worth it. It's not, however, worth it as much. Still, there is knowledge of where people are, but XCOM team does have better scouting. They do have the fleas over to the north, they have the fleas in the center. So it'll be a lot easier for them to figure out what's going on. Whereas Western team, I mean, they can scout around with glaives and they don't have to worry about the fleas stopping them or anything. They just have to be a bit more careful on expansions. Like either screen them with glaives first or set up defenders at every expansion just to stop fleas. Because they don't know where the fleas are. And defenders are like a flea bath. No, I mean, I wouldn't say it's the best veterinary advice, but maybe, just maybe, a missile tower will work to get rid of your pet's fleas. I mean, obviously that's a very extreme option, but if 0K has taught me anything, it's that missiles get rid of fleas. Very effectively. Of course, I cannot be held responsible for any damage to pets caused by missiles. So, take that as you will, I am disclaiming all responsibility. Back to the game at hand, though. Some raiding and scouting coming in. Very nice scouting from Kshatriya. Got a lot of information. Pretty much saw that Don's building for the back. Saw basically the entire base. I mean, the slashers are being known. Very nice micro there. Using that mace. I mean, though I think the slashers hit the mason more often than the glaives did. That was well done, Kshatriya. Very nice there. Impressive micro. And Sprang trying to go for the southwest. But yeah, at this point, I'd say that, yeah, everything's known. Pretty much everything's known for the Western team. They know exactly what XCOM team's up to. And XCOM team, on the other hand, is a little bit on, not quite on the ropes, but definitely having a bit of a hard time asserting territory control. Haven't even rebuilt this metal extractor yet. No masons or anything. No weavers either. Really? Well, there's a weaver up here. There's no masons, though. So yeah, that's actually kind of surprising. Kshatriya should be able to get rid of that venom, but the point is, XCOM team is having a hard time holding territory. Trying to get the standard venom red back set up to work. Really, at this point, only venoms. South side is a little bit better. Ravager, Slasher, be kind of even. It will be down to micro. Though, one extra slasher for the Western team, that's an extra hit. It's an extra set of hits. The only difference here is the leveler and the Ravagers, although the Ravagers nice pushing through, getting rid of the slashes first, but ultimately all the slashes are going to go down. Leveler did tank for the slasher on Sprang's side though, nicely done, so Sprang still goes away with one of their slashers. Should be able to get back into position and start supporting the Ravager assault. And Scythe over in the center. Sheesh, Kshatriya. They're relentless. Kshatriya also to the north to double check. There's nothing going on there. And the south battle. I mean, Sprang had pretty much won that battle anyway. And yes, Average Plan has been forced to retreat. While Kshatriya, however, to the north, having to deal with the Lightning Gun Commander, but ultimately not worrying too much because they've gotten rid of so many Metal Extractors, and they're taking the center strongly as well. XCOM team way behind economically. Militarily, they're also not doing especially well, but I think they're not dead yet. They get the Northeast, that'll help a lot, especially if they expand to that effectively. What do they have for Venom Recluse? Sorry, Venom Redback. I was expecting Redback, but no, there's Recluse. It is going for Venom Recluse. Not a bad idea to get rid of defenses, mind you. Recluses do a number on that. And Average Plan's commander, Average Plan's taking that center, not letting Sprang take it back. The entire Ice Lake belongs to Average Plan, pretty much, except for like one Metal Extractor. And even then, maybe. Although, on the other hand, Naked Expansions. This is what I mean. You have to respect the Spider. Although, admittedly, in that case, it was the leveler just destroying the Metal Extractor, or damaging it. But yeah, you have to respect the Spider Factory. Those fleas can come out of nowhere. I think that flea was the one in the mountain here the entire game. Like, that was put there at the start of the game. That did a good job. And at this point, XCOM team actually pretty close to back on par. Haven't taken the Northeast and not quite retaken the back of their base, though. I mean, there's a lot of metal. If they took the back of their base, they'd be back in action. They'd be back on top. A lot of reclaim, though. Sprang's commander doing a good job with the reclaim. But yeah, they would be ahead of Western team if they got these Metal Extractors back. They rebuilt those. I don't know why they aren't. I don't know why XCOM team is waiting on that one. I mean, Don did take the Northeast, which is good. They want that too. But if they take the Northeast and take the back, they're going to be on par. There's going to be no issues with them being able to just go toe-to-toe. I mean, at this point, the south side being retaken by Sprang, the north side has been taken pretty well by Don, and the center... It's under some assault by Kshatriya, but Kshatriya has started to get pulled back. I mean, really, Western team is having a hard time maintaining the momentum. And they aren't really building a whole lot. Looks like they're storing up metal for something. Presumably for winter. But it's currently spring. So I don't really see where the motivation is there. Although, admittedly, I guess this is... It's snowy. So on the map, it's winter. Or they're on Europa. But, you know, it's... It is kind of snowy, which does help. But Kshatriya's commander, unfortunately, is going to go down. All jokes aside, Kshatriya's commander is basically dead. Although, never mind. Kshatriya's commander, can it jump in time? The answer is... Oh, maybe one more volley potentially coming up from that recluse. Nice! Last second jump there from Kshatriya, saving their commander, keeping them ahead. Because that commander dying would pretty much put XCOM and West Team at equal economy. That was close, though. That was extremely close. I mean, Kshatriya's been doing a lot with micro. They've been doing a lot with very clutch moves. We had that Mason block from earlier, and now... I mean, the commander jump thing was kind of luck. It just so happened the reload was done by that point. But now XCOM team... They're putting a lot of pressure on the center. Taking a lot of hits to the south, though, and the north is pretty much theirs. XCOM team's got the north. They're losing the south, though. Average Plan not letting them take the south for free. Kshatriya's commander once again in iffy spot. Good thing they have slow bullets though. Disruptor ammo. Never seen that before. But the commander goes down, so XCOM team ahead economically very slightly. It's basically economic parity. XCOM team really needed that, but now Sprang's commander in the same position. Sprang, jump your commander away now. There we go. There we go. But unfortunately, those Ravagers are going to be a major problem. Nothing really in the way. And Sai is over to the northeast as well, so... This is bad. Average Plan with the Ravagers, Kshatriya with the sides, and Sprang trying desperately to defend against these Ravagers in their main base. I think they'll be able to do it. They're losing a few Masons, though, but they should. This defense should be successful. The Scythe in the Northeast, however, that's going to be just a major problem. And while the defense... Okay, the defense of the initial attack will be successful, the defense of subsequent attacks... I mean, Average Plan is just streaming in reinforcements, Ravager after Ravager coming in here. And that's 30 metal a second on Ravagers. There's a lot coming in for Ravagers. And Warriors to the center as well. Though, Team XCOM with a Ravager attack through the north. I mean, XCOM team controls the north, so they can actually do this. And this shouldn't be successful. The Warriors should be able to stop this. But at the same time, that will be a bit of a distraction. And nice, with the Fleas coming in here, the Ravagers can't easily deal with those. forcing Average Plan back, and at the same time, nicely done, Sprang getting away from the main factory, getting away from the warrior, just using the Ravager's speed to the advantage of the Ravagers. They get on the other side of these power plants, they should be able to tear most of this apart. Of course, the problem is the warriors are here. Sprang, pay attention! Be careful! If you want to keep those Ravagers alive, at least. Unfortunately, they did lose their... Oh, ouch. Sprang just lost their light vehicle factory, trying to rebuild, trying to get a hovercraft factory, but the main base taking a huge amount of damage. This is not a base trade situation. This is a very strong assault coming in from the Eastern team, sorry, from Western team. XCOM team taking loads of damage. Sprang's commander still alive. He's doing a good job. Fairly good job getting rid of the Ravagers. And Reckless is also doing a nice job. But there's just so much coming in. Average Plan's factory has not been destroyed. And those Ravagers did not manage to do much other than kill a few metal extractors. If they got rid of these caretakers, if they had managed to go far south enough to get rid of the caretakers, this would be a different story. These Ravagers would be basically it. And Average Plan's assault would have to stop. But that's not happening. That being said, Team XCOM does have an economic advantage. They do have the north pretty well taken. They are finally, they were finally retaking their metal extractors in their main base. And the northeast does need some retaking. But yes, they have an economic advantage right now. Except, oh, that's actually more naked than I thought it was. That's not good. An average plan coming with even more Ravagers. Not much to deal with this. Sprang's commander... pretty much all there is on defense for the XCOM team. And Western team with a lot of reclaim. They're reclaiming the entire front line. Sprang's commander still staying alive, though. And nice venom usage to at least get rid of these Ravagers relatively well. But it's still... this hovercraft factory is not in good position. And Scythes over to the north as well, on top of warriors in the center. Though the warriors have been basically stopped in the center. These ones over to the north as well, so the expansion destruction attempts have been stopped. XCOM team still behind, though. There's still a lot they have to do to push back in here. And Average Plan switching over to Scorchers to try to finish the job. I mean, if they're gonna throw in Halberds and Venoms, you might as well throw in Scorchers. Well, Scorchers not so much against Venoms, but against Recklesses and against Fleas, yes. And looks like a lot's working out here. The only problem is that Sprang does not have a lot of reclaim. They have some. They have the Weaver coming in. That's good. And okay, the Weaver's coming in. The Commander's coming in. There is reclaim, but this is still really tough. I mean, a lot of defenses have to be built. Basically, XCOM team is in a very tight spot where they have to be building a bunch of stuff while reclaiming. I mean, it's really hard to figure out how to prioritize build power in this situation. It's not quite panic mode, but it is difficult. However, the one upside is that they do have a lot of build power in their main base. And the factories are able to just run full blast without worrying about it. So they can at least help push the defense going. I mean, it's a battle of attrition right now, but it looks like, despite the fact that there have been a lot of setbacks, the XCOM team should be able to defend their main base, while at the same time, the Northwest has been pretty securely taken by them. I mean, the North hasn't been most securely taken, but the Northwest... and this warrior might be able to get rid of the one Lotus and the one Metal Extractor. Okay, not might. It does get rid of that, but still. That's about it. However, the main base, still under heavy assault. Lots of pressure coming into the main base. XCOM team not really breaking too much, though. They're still reclaiming. They're still setting up. Gunship plant as well. I don't think they have the money for this outright, but at the same time, they do have a lot of storage. So this could work, and they have enough energy to support this. That's the biggest thing. Their power output hasn't actually gone down too much. Or their energy output, rather, hasn't gone down too much. Which is exactly what they want. However, the Weaver's not going to survive, and that puts the Northwest expansion in a very tight spot. There's not much holding it, and right now XCOM team losing the Northwest. Things are starting to fall apart for them. They have a lot of storage, they have a lot of reclaim. I mean, their entire base, like, so much reclaim. They don't have to worry about it right now because they have a lot of storage, but yeah, they have loads of reclaim. But they will want to retake the North and Northwest and Northeast. They want to take the North side back because that was one of their biggest advantages. That's the reason they've been in this game so long, is they had the money from the North side to be able to actually deal with things. And at this point, Dominatrix is coming in for the Western team for Average Plan. Average Plan with a lot of Masons just going around, taking the South just as the XCOM team took the North, just as Don took the North. Sprang's Gunship Plant not quite done yet. I mean, clearly they're trying to rebuild their economy as best as possible. Get that set up before building up that plant, building up the gunship factory. Still, that's not a bad position. They have enough reclaim, they can pretty much get away with it now that they have all this energy. I mean, just for the insurance, because they don't know. They could lose the entire north side. There are still a couple solar plants. There are still a couple, well, no wind generators. But there was still energy. And these fleas are not going to do the trick, I'm afraid. This is going to be a very one-sided battle in favor of the glaives. Although, the hermits are going to be of some help, but venoms would be really nice. South side, more dominatrices coming in. Some dominating happening, but the scalpels pretty much counter that directly. Homing weapons, that's how you get rid of things that retreat annoyingly, like dominatrices. Still, average plan with a beachhead at the south side of the XCOM base. The thing is, average plan has committed a lot to this. This entire area, if that gets attacked heavily, average plan has basically no backup. Actually, for that matter, the Western team has no backup. They're entirely based on offense right now. Entirely. Offense and reclaim. That is what they're building off entirely. Now, there's a lot of reclaim for XCOM team, but they're on the defender's advantage. If average plan loses this, they're going to be pretty far behind. That's actually a bit of a chance for the XCOM team to get back in this. But the West team, Zeus coming in here, and more scalpels. No. Slashers. Gah! It's 5 in the morning, and when it's 5 in the morning, I get my standard sk problem. If anyone not familiar, I can't seem to tell the units with sk in their name or s in their name apart. Slashers, scalpels, scorchers. Doesn't matter. I just get them mixed up. I don't know what it is. Anyway, the north side, destruction in the north has been pretty much complete by the west team. The Waxcon team, they do still have a lot of reclaim. They do have the brawlers as well. So while the north side is going to be destroyed, it could very quickly be rebuilt as soon as a weaver gets up there. There's not going to be much to stop a rebuild. All these units are basically gone. Kshatriya has lost everything to the north. They have enough of an economy they can rebuild pretty trivially, but still, that's not good. That's pretty bad. That's pretty annoying. Pyrrhic victory. Definitely. That's what Kshatriya has achieved right now in the north. But no weavers are in play right now to the north. They are more in the main base, and they are reclaiming quite nicely too. So XCOM team still reclaiming. Air factory, however, has been built for Kshatriya. Sorry, for average plan. And there was no other gunships coming in. A brawler was under production, but it stopped. Penetrator coming in. Pretty much the trump card. This is Sprang's trump card. This is what they're going to be trying to basically break this beachhead with. Is that one penetrator. And I guess also the brawlers. Okay, they do actually have more brawlers. And, oh, if they get rid of that stinger, that's going to be really powerful. But they don't, unfortunately. And the Hawks do put a stop to those brawlers, or at least make the brawlers' lives a lot harder. And also reveal the penetrator. Unfortunately, that penetrator is going to have a nice 10-second reload time. Or 20-second reload time, I'm sorry. 20-second reload time. It's not going to be easily able to deal with this. What do they know, though? Oops. Okay, they know quite a lot. Oops. Well, they know a bit. They actually have a radar shadow right where most of average plan's forces are. So, no, actually, at this point, XCOM team does not know where Western team's forces are. And West team, they are pretty well set up for another powerful assault here. A lot of Zeus's, a lot of gremlins for anti-air. Stupid selection widget's gone and broke on me again. Why does that keep happening? Seriously, I thought that was... Oh, right, that's fixing next stable. That's what the problem is. The next stable thing. Ah, sorry about that. Are we still on 4... we're still on 1434. Yeah, so next stable, apparently that's been fixed. I don't know why that keeps happening. Something about selecting an enemy unit. I don't know. Actually, I should probably download the most recent thing, but we'll see. If there's time between matches, but I kind of doubt it since we're at the 18-minute mark. And like I said before, 25 minutes, that's when tie-breaking is... Or not tie-breaking, but arbitration determinant. And then half-hour mark is when it's either a draw or we check for advantage again. So at this point, I'd say that it's actually fairly close. I'd have to check to the Deluxe player list, but I'm fairly certain that this is about even. Kind of curious. I'm going to just pull that up for a moment. Yeah, at this point, it looks like... Okay, Avatron and Kshatriya do have an advantage, but it's not a 2x advantage. It's about 1.5 times. So this is going to be interesting, because that's a big deal. I probably should pull this over here, just to make it out of the way. So yeah, right now, there's no easy way of determining a victor. My tournament rules do not determine a victor in this situation, so we may have a draw game. I kind of doubt it, though. It looks like Average Plan is managing to get some momentum with the Ravens. Continuing to push back Sprang, and at this point, XCOM team is running low on reclaim sources. They do have the Northeast again, though, and they do have all this reclaim to work with if they get workers up there securely. And the Caretaker, actually, here, yeah, there's quite a lot of metal. So reclaim is not going to be an issue for XCOM team. The main issue is going to be taking out the Southwest. They have taken out the Stinger to the Southeast. They have taken out the Stinger, but they still are on the back foot. Still nice scalpel usage. I mean, the Penetrator clearly didn't really do much. But still, nice scalpel usage nonetheless. If they get rid of these Masons, that'll actually be quite effective, because that'll stop most of the rebuilding. Average Plan's commander has retreated back to their base, and building a Dante, trying to finish this off. Get that Dante up. Looks like we aren't seeing anything coming up from Kshatriya. They do have the Northwest, though. Finally have what is rightfully theirs, or at least in theory rightfully theirs, what's closest to them. At this point, the economies are still on par, though, mostly because of Reclaim, but that's what Reclaim is for. And the Masons have been forced back as well, so Average Plan's beachhead pretty much gone. Not completely, but it is pretty much gone. It's going to be difficult to hold that. Yeah, the Mace is going to come in to finish this off, get rid of the Air Factory. The Dante, however, is the big deal, though. When the Dante's up, I mean, I don't know. I think XCOM team will be able to build defenses in time. They don't know the Dante's up. They don't have any air forces. A few gnats just scattered around the map to try to scout it out, see if there's anything coming in, or just a good read on, hey, a Strider might be coming in right now. That would be handy, but I don't think losing the Dante is going to be the biggest deal. The Dante, obviously, is going to be a big problem to have to be dealt with, but I don't think that getting rid of it's going to just win the game for XCOM team. But I do think they'll be able to deal with it. Actually, I'd be surprised if they don't build their own at this point. Admittedly, that would be a bad idea, but still, they might. Airplane factory down, north side, still being hit hard by Kshatriya. And they've pretty much taken the north center. There's a brawler trying to say something about that, but otherwise not much. At this point, though, the thing is, Western team has an information advantage. They've been putting Hawks inside of XCOM team's base. They have a vulture just flying around the map. They pretty much know everything, whereas XCOM team doesn't know that there's a Dante coming. They don't know the structure of the base right now. They really don't know anything for the last 10 minutes. They haven't seen their opponent's base at all. They've seen very little. And in terms of metal cost comparison, Average Plan with that Dante actually does have a pretty big metal lead. And I'm kind of curious if the players are going to try to get just as much metal in their units as possible and not die. Because at this point, there's only 2 minutes left before that check is made, that first check. And right now, it's about even. It's not quite double. Don has about, sorry, Team 1 has about 9k metal. Team 2 has about 13k metal. So there's no doubling yet. Like, this game is going to continue past the 25-minute mark most likely. And the Northwest, so North side is still turning into a bit of a stalemate. But at this point, yeah, it's not doubled yet. And that Dante goes down. I mean, the next Dante coming up, I think that might be what Average Plan and Kshatriya are trying to do right now, is just build up all the units. I mean, clearly they're trying to win by destroying. But, no, maybe just build faster. And an Infiltrator coming in, stopping the Dante. Penetrator up as well to help deal with the Dante. And this Dante should be stunned out for few more seconds. Infiltrator forced to get out of the way, but still. Yet another Infiltrator coming in here. That should stun it out. Yep, and that Dante is down again. That Dante's totally down. That's reclaimed food. Where is the nearest worker? All right, they're all the base. They're all building up. That was a lot lost for very little. I mean, XCOM team didn't have to do much to deal with that. Done just sending a couple infiltrators. And they still have the two infiltrators, so the next Dante is going to be even easier to deal with. Just rebuild the metal extractors and they'll be fine. But Psy's coming in from the north. That's going to be an issue again. And at this point, average planning Kshetra, still not quite double. Although, these sides are going to be quite... They're going to work. You can get rid of the caretakers. Probably not get rid of the Spiderbot factory, but getting rid of the caretakers is a big deal. That's a lot of production power that's just been lost. And we close in on the 25-minute mark. We have 9.5 to 12.4. So, nope. We continue on. The game keeps going. Not quite a stalemate, but the two teams are not really giving any ground. I mean, at this point, another Dante is forth... Oh, is it forthcoming? No, it's forthcoming, yeah. Another one's coming. Fusion plant on top of that. But yeah, there's no easy way for that Dante to actually do anything. It can't attack easily. The infiltrators will get it. And if it's on defense, it's not doing much. So no clear advantage, no clear winner, and it looks like XCOM team... I mean, they're a bit behind economically, though. But it could very well be a draw. And we will be reminded why I don't particularly like Cold Snap all that much, because it tends to happen with draws. We have 4 minutes to a draw. Like, or potentially a draw. Don's pretty low on units, but still, it's... Yeah, at this point, it's actually pretty close between Average Plan and Kshatriya. I mean, Average Plan and Sprang are the same. Well, maybe. I don't know. It's getting close. Kshatriya is really pumping out the units. I think part of the game plan might just be pump out as many units as possible in order to get their values as high as possible, but I don't know if that's going to work. Because, I mean, at some point, you're dealing with the fact that your opponent is still trying to kill you, because at this point... West team could easily get the advantage on units, but the Eastern team wants probably to win directly. Actually, at this point, it's still even. It's like 11k to 14k. So no, there's no one getting advantage on units. If no one wins outright in the next 3 minutes, we are going to have a draw here. First draw, apparently. Another penetrator coming up, and well, actually three penetrators already, a fourth one about to come in. Nice flail usage there, getting rid of the bombers, stopping them from getting to the penetrators. No infiltrators to help with the Dante, though. Penetrators are probably going to be dealing with that as soon as they can, but yeah, nothing to get rid of that. And Don with an air plant of their own over to the northeast. They've taken the northeast pretty securely, too. And they're actually focusing on that. And Western team not really got in the northwest. Don't really have their main base. Haven't got much to work with. And there's 2.5 minutes left until a draw. I'm expecting we're going to see a big push in about 30 seconds as both teams try their hardest to break the other team and not get a draw. We have missile silo coming in from Kshatriya. Inferno missiles, as usual. Very typical thing to do. And I'm pretty sure that we're going to see Sprang just push in probably in a about 5-10 seconds. Like, it looks like this is the start of the big push. Like, they're going to go over the top because that's all they have. They have 2 minutes left to possibly play this game out. I mean, as long as enough damage is dealt without it being a Pyrrhic victory, it's going to be a win for XCOM team. Otherwise, it's going to be a draw. I don't think West team can easily get a win at this point. I mean, they might be able to... Ooh, nice. Well, I mean, good penetrator setup there. Scalpels, if they can get rid of the... Ooh, that penetrator... Oh, both penetrators... All the penetrators going down! That's really bad for the army count, army value. This point's 11k to 18k. And the penetrator... Another penetrator going to go down. Ah, this point, we might actually have... Well, maybe not quite a clear win. It's not quite a clear win yet. But from a tactical perspective, I mean, that was a huge loss. The Maces are doing a nice job getting rid of the Scorchers, but that was a huge loss. That was 8,000 metal That was just gone. Oh, sorry, 4,000 metal, not 8,000. 4,000 metal, that's just gone. Trying to get rid of 3,500 metal units. And Inferno's coming in, getting the main base as well. So, a lot of damage from the Western team to the XCOM team, but I don't know if this is quite enough. It doesn't look like it is. 12k to 19k, no! 40 seconds left, we look like we're going to be having a draw here. And trying to get rid of the Zeuses. XCOM team trying desperately to get rid of the Zeuses. I mean, at this point, XCOM team can only hope for a draw. They have 25 seconds left. It's 13k to 20k. As long as XCOM team maintains draw, and is this... Okay, 10 seconds left. We have 13k to 20k. It is a draw. There is no way it is not a draw. And yeah, I kind of agree that that was a bit of iffy timing, but... That was a draw. Okay, so... Yeah. We have the first draw. Probably a good thing we did Swiss style, because that actually supports draws pretty well. Like, draws are a valid outcome in a Swiss style tournament. But yeah. Draw! So... I mean, that was an interesting-ish game. It certainly went... I mean, the north side capture was interesting, too. And the Dantes... Oh, the Dantes revealed both infiltrators as well, but still, I mean... Wolverine's coming in, and... I don't know if that Dante would survive much longer. Actually, at this point... Oh, wow, if it was a minute later... A minute later, and Kshatriya would have taken it... Or, well... West team would have taken it. Okay, so I'm not sure how this is going to be ruled, because... Basically a minute out, and... A minute out from there. And Western team won. Okay, so not sure if it's going to be a draw or if it's going to be a West team win. That's kind of up to Swordtail. I mean, the rule was 30 minutes and it's a draw, but there was another little thing about a 5-minute extra. I don't know how this is going to go. I don't know what the ruling is going to be. I do know that the next round is going to be going, though, so that'll work. But I don't know how the ruling is going to be, because it was something a bit weird. Oh, brackets matches are 30 minutes with potentially 5 minutes extra. So the, instead of 25 and 30, it's 30 and 35. Anyway, that was a bit weird. That was a weird way for things to go. I don't really know what to say to that. But that was an interesting game nonetheless. I mean, we had that North capture by the XCOM team. That was cool. I mean, that's one thing about Cold Snap I've noticed, is that it's not the clearest for how it splits things over. Like, you might split things up where, in one case, it's... Like, well, I mean, kind of North-South versus East-West. Especially when everyone starts to the south. Ah, oh, man. I wish Ubiquitous worked with Twitch chat. Whatever. Sorry, everybody watching on Twitch. I haven't been able to see your chat messages in real time because my program that I normally use to see chat messages doesn't want to work with Twitch right now for some reason. But now we're good. I've got it sorted out, so don't worry about it. Keep talking. All right, so it looks like if everyone agrees, then it is a clear win. If everyone agrees that East team lost, and Don's voting for the draw, because I guess why wouldn't you? Yeah, this is a weird situation. But hey, that's why you have tournament administrators, because when you have weird situations, admittedly caused by slightly unorthodox tournament rules, you end up with rulings. You have to have rulings. I don't know, this is a bit weird. Well, however this is ruled, okay, it looks like it is going to be ruled a draw. But the way that Swiss works, that's fine. That actually is okay. Because now, basically, there's still four teams. I mean, it's the top four teams. So right now, it looks like it's going to be like Shattering Average Plan versus Baladoom and Dying Friend. That's the, like, sorry, not Baladoom and Dying Friend. Well, yeah, that one's actually gonna be a big one. And also, I'm guessing Norman Spring. No. So Sprung and Hoko are not against Flores and El Torero, interestingly enough. Sprung and Hokomoko are against Norm and Anarchid. That's the game I'm going to watch, by the way. It's going to be Sprung Hokomoko versus Norm 616 and Anarchid. But, yeah, that's actually, I think, okay, not quite guaranteed. If Norm 616 and Anarchid win, then it's going to be 2 points each, and they're both going to be guaranteed top spot. They're going to be guaranteed passage into the bracket stage. If Sprung and Hokomoko win, then I think it depends on the others. Like, if Kshatriya and Average Plan, if Sprung and Dunn and Kshatriya and Average Plan both lose, but if one of them wins, then Norm 616 and Anarchid, I think, will go down because of that 0.5 score. So yeah, this is really tight. Alright, so that was a draw. Next match is going to be Sprung and Hokomoko. Hopefully not on Cold Snap, because I'm kind of getting sick of that map. Where are they going to be going? So Sprung, okay, now I know where they are. We can start this up. Oh, whoops, I don't know if it's going to be Cold Snap. It might be, looks like it's going to be Wanderlust. Is Wanderlust on the map list? I don't think it is. I don't recall seeing it on the map list. Oh, it is! Okay, so we are going to be on Wanderlust. From probably going to be on Wanderlust. Okay. Oh, is Ball of Doom filling in for Anarchid? No, that's, they're in the wrong room. Okay, anyway, sorry, I'm commenting on things you guys can't see. So, yeah, there's not going to be a rematch. We're being asked, is it going to be a rematch? No, that's not how it works. Draws are a valid outcome in a Swiss bracket. Now, in the elimination bracket, that's going to be an issue. But in a Swiss bracket, that's not. In Swiss, that's fine. Because you just get half a point each. And that gets used for figuring out who's winning, who's losing, all that stuff. Like, who's actually on the top of the bracket. Right, so with that, I think. Just waiting to see if people, what people choose. Wouldn't mind seeing Wanderlust here. But I don't really know. Ay. All right, so I'm guessing we're going to be... Actually, who's going to choose this? I'm curious. I mean, at this point, we could have the team with the lower score choose it. Well, not always, because not all the scores are lower. Actually, maybe. Hang on. Sprung and... Yeah, actually, they are. In every single case, there is a team with a lower score. All right, so it looks like we're going to be on Vitra. That's not a bad map for 2v2. Or are we? Okay, whatever. Some organization issues coming in. But yeah, so Sprung and Okamoko we saw last game did that cheesy strategy. Really cheesy warrior drop. Didn't work out, but they did it anyway. I mean, they won, but that drop didn't work. So now, Norm and Anarchid, I'm curious what they're going to do. We have not seen them yet. They are the only team we have not yet seen play. Everyone else, actually, we haven't seen Baladum and Dinefriend play either. But yeah, we have seen... We have seen Sprung and Dine. We just saw them. We saw Cheshire and Abbas plan as well last game, so... What map is this going to be on? Okay, it looks